So today we are going to discuss the theoretical aspect of the histology of the tongue. Tongue is mucomuscular organ. So in this, muco means the mucosa. So tongue is basically composed of the one part that is known as the mucosa, another part that is known as the skeletal muscle. Now within the skeletal muscle you have pattern that is of three types: longitudinal, horizontal, as well as the oblique type of the muscle fibers. They are found in the structure of the tongue. Okay, in between the muscle fibers you can also find the various types of the glands, also the mucus as well as the serous glands are also present between the this type of the fibers. Okay, next one, that is the mucosa, that is having the four subdivisions. Okay, first one, that is the epithelium. Second one, underlying the epithelium there is a presence of lamina propria. Third one, that is the papillae. Okay, and fourth one, that is the glands. First we will discuss the epithelium. Epithelium is of non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Still there are some exceptions where this non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium is replaced by the keratinized. Where this replacement happens, we will discuss this later on. Now underneath the epithelium you will find the lamina propria, which is chiefly composed of the loose type of the connective tissue. Okay, now there is a formation of the papilla by the lamina propria underneath the epithelium of the tongue, and this papillae you can find the various type of the shapes in the papillae. According to the shape of that papillae is classified into the four types. First one, that is the filiform type of the papillae. Here you can see the conical type of the shape in the papillae, and this, the tip of that cone is lined by the keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Second one, that is the fungiform type of the papillae is there, and the shape of that papillae is something looking like the mushroom. Third one, that is the circumvallate papillae, and the shape of that is dome shape. Okay, and also at the base of that circumvallate papillae you will find the circular sulcus, or also known as the trench or the furrow. Now the fourth one, that is the foliate papillary, that is not usually found in the human because it's rudimentary. They are normally found in the rabbit. Okay, so remember this foliate papillae, the last one, fourth one, that is rudimentary in the human, so that is not found. Now the glands, two types of the glands they are seen, that is known as the serous as well as the mucous gland. Okay, now serous gland, they are given a specific name that is known as the von Ebner serous gland, and mucous gland they are simply known as the lingual mucous gland. Okay, so this is something regarding the basic ideas, basic concept, how you should study the histology of the tongue. Next we are moving towards the one picture of the cadaver that is taken in the mid sagittal section of the head and neck. Here you can see this portion, that is the oral cavity. This one is the maxillary bone along with the soft tissues. This is the mandible. Okay, so here you can see this central core of the tongue. This is the tongue. So the central core of this tongue, that is formed by the striated muscles that is running in various directions. Okay, now the surface of the tongue that is divided into the two portions. So one, that is facing the open oral cavity here, this portion dome shape that is termed as the dorsal surface, and that is somewhat rough due to the presence of the papillae. So papillae, they are present onto the dorsal surface of the tongue. Now this is the ventral surface of the tongue that is mostly connected with the mandible and some anterior portion that is free. Okay, so this is the ventral surface of the tongue, but that is mostly smooth in nature because there is no presence of the lamellae on this aspect, ventral surface of the tongue. Okay, next, in this cadaveric image you can see the division of the tongue as well as the types of the papillae that you can see with the naked eye. So this is the sulcus terminalis. You can see this sulcus here, that is the sulcus terminalis that is dividing the dorsal surface of the tongue into the two portions. This area is the anterior two-third portion and this area is the posterior two-third portion. So this anterior area mostly containing the papillae, while this posterior area that is not having the papillae, but you will find the more irregular surface that is seen onto the posterior aspect, that is due to the presence of the underlying lymphatic tissue collection. Okay, so you can see this is the posterior aspect. Now just anterior to this sulcus terminalis you will find this circular structure here as well as here. Okay, so that is termed as the circumvallate papillae. Okay, so this structure is termed as the circumvallate papillae. Now in the anterior portion again you will find the elevated structure that is known as the fungiform papillae, and in between the fungiform papillae you will find the gaps, and that is termed as the filiform papillae. So filiform papillae, they are numerous in number. Okay, so they are the largest number of the papillae that is found in the tongue. Okay, so this is regarding the gross anatomy, something regarding the gross anatomy of the tongue. Now we are actually moving towards this schematic diagram of the tongue, what we have to see. So this is particularly the diagram for the dorsal aspect of the tongue. Okay, so in this schematic diagram, number one, you can see the various types of the elevations. Okay, they are formed here. Okay, so that is termed as the tongue papillae or the, okay, simple you can say, the papillae, and that is formed by the elevations of this region that is termed as the lamina propria. Okay, here you can see the lamina propria that is chiefly composed of the loose connective tissue. Number two, that is the type of the epithelium. The most of the epithelium that is lined by the non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, except at the tip of this type of papillae, that is the filiform papillae, and that is having some type of keratinization is there. Number four, you can see here the arrangement of the skeletal muscle fiber that is in various form, longitudinal, transverse as well as the oblique. Number five, you can look at here, that is the secondary papillae that is just opposite to this primary papillae. You can also find this type of elevation that is termed as the secondary papillae. Number six, you can find the mushroom shaped elevation here of the papillae along with this epithelium that is termed as the fungiform papillae. Number seven, okay, you can here see, look at that, is the gland that is known as the serous type of the acini, or also known as the one Ebner's gland. Okay, number eight, here you can see the furrow sulcus or the trench that is surrounding the circumvallate papillae. This is the number nine, that is known as the circumvallate papillae. At the base you will find the groove or the furrow, okay, that is separating this papillae from the rest of the epithelium. Now on to the base of this trench or furrow, you will find the openings of this type of gland, that is the serous gland. Okay, one Ebner serous gland. So the opening of the duct of this serous gland just at the base of this furrow. Number 10, onto the lateral wall of this circumvallate papillae, you can find this type of structure that is termed as the test buds, okay, which is mainly responsible for the test sensation. Now, this test buds, they are normally present onto the lateral wall of the circumvallate papillae, okay, as well as that is also present onto the top surface of this fungiform papillae. The test buds, they are normally absent in the filiform papillae, and also they are present in the foliate papillae, but that is not normally seen in the human. Number 11, the last one that you can look at here, this is again one type of gland that is known as the mucous acini. Mucous gland is here. So that is something regarding it, and this is the blood vessel also here. You can see this is the blood vessel. So this is something regarding the schematic diagram, which are the structures that you have to see under the microscope in the slide of the tongue. Next one, we are discussing the various types of the papillae that you can find on the tongue, as well as the structure of the test bud. First one, that is the conical projected type of papillae is seen, that is known as the filiform papillae. So that is mainly filling the gap. This is not the papillae that is responsible for the test sensation. The function of this type of papillae, the filiform papillae, is to just hold the food under the tongue surface and to increase the friction between the tongue surface as well as the food. Second one, this type of dome shaped, or you can say the mushroom shaped papillae, okay, that is known as the fungiform papillae, onto the top surface you can find the position of the test buds. Okay, and this is something like forming a dome shaped area, that is known as the circumvallate papillae. Here there is an absence of test pore onto the surface, but this is the furrow, okay, that is demarcating the line between the epithelium and the circumvallate papillae. So onto the walls of this furrow you will find the various test buds. Okay, now this is the something structure regarding the test bud. So this is looking like the you can say the something looking like the onion shape. Okay, so this area is termed as the test pore, which opens onto the surface of the tongue, and this is the basal area. Okay, so in this structure of the test bud, you can look at the three types of the cells are there. Okay, first you can see the small cell here, that is known as the basal cells, small cells there which are not reaching up to the epithelium, top aspect of the epithelium. Okay, they are just confined within the basal aspect of the test bud. This is termed as the basal cell, and they are mainly responsible for the generation of the remaining two types of the cell, that is the sensory cell, that is known as the principal cells or the neuroepithelial cell, as well as the supporting cells. Okay, so basically three types of the cells that you will see: basal cell, sensory hair cells, as well as the supporting cells. So the test function is mainly confined with the sensory hair cell, which is of the bipolar neuron. So one process that is going into the test pore, okay, and another process that is forming the nerve ending axon terminal here. Okay, so this is the structure of the sensory hair cell, and this is the supporting cell. It has the function to support the sensory hairs. Okay, so this is something regarding the types of the papillae that you will find in the tongue surface, and this is regarding the structure of the test bud. Now the structure of the test bud, that is something similar with the onion, particularly when you take the half section of the onion. Okay, so here you can see the half section of the onion to make you remember about the structure of the test buds. So again, in this half section of the onion, you will find some slices. Okay, here you will find some slices. They are not reaching from the root of the onion up to this apical portion. So this small slices, they are resembling with the basal cells of the test pole, which are responsible for the generation of the supporting cells as well as the receptor cells. Now, in this cut section, there are some slices they are running from basal aspect up to the apical region. So this is the slices, they are representing the supporting cells as well as the receptor cells. Okay, and this is the root of the onion that is representing the afferent nerve fibers, okay, which are coming from the sensory bipolar neuron. Okay, and in between the receptor cells you will find the supporting cells also. This is the position resembling with the taste pores. Okay, and at last this onion is covered also with the onion peel or the skin. This skin or the peel of the onion that is representing the stratified squamous epithelium. Mostly non-keratinization is there, but at the tip of the filiform papillae you will find the keratinization also. So this is to make you somewhat, to make your understanding somewhat more easier as far as the taste buds are concerned. Okay, we will discuss the identification points of the histology slide of the tongue in a next video. Thank you very much for watching.